Blackstone Audio presents Gettysburg Rebels, Five Native Sons Who Came Home to Fight as Confederate Soldiers by Tom McMillan. This book is read by Paul Michael Garcia.
To At, who encouraged me to dream, and to Colleen, who made sure that I did. Author's Note. I was different from other Gettysburg battlefield trampers. I was often drawn to obscurity. I would whisk past Devil's Den and Little Round Top and the field of Pickett's Charge to find myself at an often ignored corner of the Emmitsburg and Wheatfield Roads, where a plain iron tablet next to an old stone foundation reads simply, Wentz House. How poetic. It was here that an elderly Adams County resident, John Wentz, crouched in his cellar during the Battle of Gettysburg on July 2, 1863, unaware, at least at first, that his son, Henry, who had grown up in that house, was posted 600 yards away as an artillery sergeant in the Confederate Army. Henry Wentz's homecoming as an enemy soldier has intrigued me since the day I first read about it in Harry Font's Gettysburg, The Second Day. I wanted to learn more about him, to read and study more, to advance the story in my own mind. But, alas, very little was available in books. Like many other soldiers in the Civil War, Henry did not write about his experiences, or if he did, nothing has survived. No one has seen his photo or any of his possessions. He was and is a mystery. And perhaps he preferred it that way. But I decided to explore. I came up with an idea to write a book about two young men from Gettysburg who had fought as Confederates in the Battle of Gettysburg, Henry Wentz and Wesley Culp, whose name is better known because of his family's hometown roots. In the process, however, I learned that three brothers named Hoffman had also grown up in Gettysburg and become rebel soldiers, and that all three had direct connections to Culp. Thus, Gettysburg Rebels was born. The research was a challenge because Culp was killed in the battle, and none of the others wrote about his actions during this cataclysmic period in the nation's history. Aside from Culp's, no portraits of the men exist, though perhaps an unknown descendant will dig into a box and come forward with one after this is published. But I decided that a lack of such traditional evidence should not deter me. These men's stories still deserved to be told. Uncovering those stories took me on an amazing journey to places I'd never been, Shepherdstown and Martinsburg, and some I'd never heard of. Linden and Warrenton, in addition to Harper's Ferry and Gettysburg. I scanned countless pages of oversized county deed books that probably had not been opened for 100 years, and sifted through wills, tax records, church records, newspaper service records, and pension applications at the National Archives. I met and was helped by many wonderful people along the way. The story in these pages is certainly not the complete account of Henry Wentz, Wesley Culp, and the three Hoffman brothers, but I'm convinced it is the closest anyone has come. Perhaps it will spark more dogged research, and the uncovering of more clues, maybe even a photo. In the meantime, I hope that you enjoy the narrative presented here. The story of five young men who grew up in the North, fought for the South, and marched on their old hometown with an invading army in July 1863. However you judge them, they will no longer be obscure. Tom McMillan, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, December 2016. Introduction. 50 miles from the Gettysburg battlefield, on a gently sloping hill behind the Green Hill Cemetery Mausoleum in Martinsburg, West Virginia. A weather-beaten and barely legible tombstone marks the final resting place of one of the fascinating figures of the American Civil War. Henry Wentz died December 10, 1875, aged 48 years. The Stark Memorial offers no tribute to his 4 years of artillery service for the Confederate States of America, makes no mention of his deeds on fields of honor at Manassas, Sharpsburg, Mechanicsville, or, hauntingly, Gettysburg. It is as though the friends and family of Henry Wentz did not comprehend the extraordinary role in America's great cataclysm of a man who invaded his own hometown with a foreign army and fired on the house where he grew up. Born in nearby York County, Pennsylvania, in 1827, Wentz was just turning 9 years old when his family moved to the Gettysburg area. His father, John, bought a 1.5-story log and weatherboard house along the Emmitsburg Road in Cumberland Township, barely a mile from the Gettysburg town line, and adjacent to a peach orchard that would one day merit its own place in American history. Henry spent his formative years there, maturing into adulthood and becoming a local landowner himself before moving to northwestern Virginia in 1852. He settled in Martinsburg in what became West Virginia, found work as a plasterer, joined a local militia unit called the Martinsburg Blues, and enlisted in the Confederate Army when war broke out in 1861. If Orderly Sergeant Wentz felt a strange queasiness 2 years later as the Army of Northern Virginia thundered into south-central Pennsylvania, he would not have been alone. 4 other men in Robert E. Lee's invading force had grown up in Gettysburg. John Wesley Culp, from one of the borough's most prominent families and a private in Company B of the 2nd Virginia Infantry, was immortalized when he fell in battle near his cousin's farm. The 3 remaining Gettysburg rebels, however, were unknown even to Civil War historians for well over 130 years. These were the Hoffman brothers, Robert, Frank, and Wesley. Their father, C.W. Hoffman, had been one of Gettysburg's leading citizens, but in 1856 he suddenly, and somewhat mysteriously.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.